Jada Colagrande presented a last movie padre at Regent Street Cinema in London, accompanied by his husband and colleague Willem Dafoe. Jada, the actress, writer and the movie's director, tell us how everything started for the creation of this intimate movie released just after her father's death.
It honestly started from some dreams that I had, where I saw exactly what I did in the movie. I saw myself, a woman that had just lost her father. There were some differences. My father, my real father, was not a composer, but that's what I dreamt. So I wrote down these dreams and turned them into a script. And I made the movie exactly in the same way I made my first movie. This is my fourth fiction film. This is the first time I do use some autobiographical element. Otherwise, I normally am not a big fan of of that. It must be because I normally make very personal movies, but they're personal in a different way, and that little distance, you know, that comes from the invention of the narrative elements, at least, gives me more freedom, because I don't feel guided by my personal emotions about my real life.
Willem Dafoe, Franco Battiato and also Marina Abramovic are very close to Jada's real life, and this is one of the reasons why they are part of the cast. But the movie's director reveals what really happened before she decided to involve them.
And honestly, Willem, Franco and Marina, I saw in this the dreams that I was telling you about. For example, I remember clearly that the third night that I had these dreams, I saw for the first time the face of the father, and it was Franco Battiato's face. So I told him, I called him and I told him what was happening, that I was having these consecutive dreams for the first time in my life. And he was so happy about it. He thought it was a great sign.
Dafoe instead reveals what was his first reaction when her wife wanted him to be involved in this particular film, speaking also in Italian.
It's exciting. You know, of course, we talk all the time about things that she wants to do, but this came in such a lucid, clear way, and I really just had to step back and get out of her way. I think she wanted it to be in Italian as much as possible, and it reflects our life, because in our lives we speak some Italian, some English. It's filmed in our neighborhood. There are many things that not because she wants to expose that necessarily, but it's a way of working. She took all the things around her.
James, the character Dafoe is interpreting, is very close to Julia, the protagonist, and he explains the relationship they have in the movie.
There's no paternalism or no sexual stuff to work through, so they have a confidence that I've only seen between gay men and women sometimes. And that was important. So it was interesting because in life, we are a married couple. It was interesting to play that.
Padre is not just a movie. It's a complete experience and journey that both Jada and Julia had and that they want to share to make us explore the invisible world.
Julia's path through these steps, as you rightfully call them, is pretty much the same path I went through right before and even during the film. The movie is divided in seven parts, or let's call them chapters, and every chapter has a sentence that's like a title to the chapter. Those sentences come from a book by Rudolf Steiner called The Initiation. And that book was, for me, very much of a manual, very much of a guide through a gradual initiation, really, to the invisible world. London One Radio.